Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. Before you will start, let us pray first. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we praise and glorify your name. We thank you for the countless blessings that you have bestowed on us, especially the gift of life. We hope and pray that you send forth your Holy Spirit in each one of us and continue to guide us in everything that we do and in everywhere that we go. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I would like to congratulate you all for a very successful Abilidaren 2024. I'm very happy and very proud of your achievements as well as your participation in the several competitions that you have participated. And for first year student, you actually showed how capable and how competent you are, even though you are still freshman students. Now, nagklase lang kog early, no? Since I have an oral defense by 7, so most probably we are going to start early so that before, no, mga minutes before 7, we're already done. Masking halfway lang sa ito ang discussion for this evening. So we are going to open with a new topic tonight, and which is the profile and history of Negros Occidental. We are already done with Sagay City, and then although no medyo taas-taas man ang history ni or profile no ni Negros Occidental, hopefully mahuman man ato ang tunga-tunga, no, because medyo taas-taas ang ato ang i-discuss when it comes to the cultural features of Negros Occidental. Okay, so let me share my screen first. Okay, wait, thank you. Okay, for a while, okay, so welcome to our part 2, no, of lesson 2, which is cultural features of Negros Occidental. So in here, no, you are going to learn, this is just basically a continuation of what we discussed last time on the history of Sagay, but this time we are going to take it to a step further, no, into the whole province na jud ang ato ang i get to know, no, at the same time. We are also going to know what are the main highlights of Negros Occidental that makes it different from any other provinces. So, Negros Occidental faces the island province of Guimaras and the province of Iloilo on Panay Island, which is northwest across the Panay Gulf and the Guimaras Strait. Now, there are, although most of the municipalities and cities are facing Panay and Guimaras, no, But there are also several municipalities and cities that are facing Cebu Province, no? Which is part na po may ana, no, kaming mga naa sa San Carlos, sa Calatrava, that's why we speak in Bisaya, no? Or Bisaya, they rather. So, Bacolod is the capital and the seat of government of Negros Occidental, and it is also considered as the most populous city of the province. So, we talk about populous, no? Daghan sila og population. The population of 2,497,261 inhabitants. Although, Bacolod is considered as the seat of government, but it is also governed independently as a highly urbanized city. Hindi makasulod si... Okay, wait lang. Sulod ko sa si Trixie. So why DC? Okay. So since considered man si Bacolod City, you know, as one of the most populous, or the populous rather, populous city of the province. So, not only that, no, not only in the province, but a province of Negros Occidental rather. But Negros Occidental is also considered as the most populated province in the Western Visayas region. And if we are going to combine the entire Visayas, no, kita ang ikaduha. So, take note, in the entire province of Negros Occidental, Bacolod is the most populous city. Since even though it's the seat of government, governed po siya independently as a highly urbanized city. Okay? And then, if we are going to compare Negros Occidental with the other provinces in Western Visayas, like Panay and Guimaras, okay? Okay, within Panay, naaman tayo Capiz, Aklan, okay? So, kani sila class, kani mga different provinces, ang pinakadaghan po dog population is Negros Occidental. Okay? Most populated province in Western Visayas. Now, if ato po siyang i-compare sa Eastern and Central Visayas, no, with also Western Visayas, si Negros Occidental ang second, no, most populous province and the eighth most populous province in the Philippines. Okay, so when it comes to geography, no, we are located in the western side of Negros Island, the fourth largest island in the Philippines, with a total land area of 7,802.54 square kilometers or 3,012.58 square miles. So this is excluding Bacolod. Okay, so makita man mo nga we occupy most of the Negros Island, although we share Negros Island with Negros Oriental, we still occupy most of it, no? Given nga, naaman si Toboso, si Escalante, Vito, Calatrava, San Carlos, no? Naaman siya diri sa part ni Occidental. So, if itong i-include si Bacolod for geographical purposes, kay syempre gina-exclude mong good siya tungod kay it's the seat of power. But if you include Bacolod, so ang area no ni Negros Occidental is 7,965.21 square kilometers or 3,075.38 square miles. So the province is approximately 375 kilometers long from north to south. It is bounded by the Visayan Sea in the north, Panay Gulf on the west, Negros Oriental Province and Tanyon Strait on the east, and Sulu Sea on the south. So basically kami ng mga taga San Carlos, no, we actually pass by Tanyon Strait going to Cebu. Okay? Mudok mi sa Toledo, sa karami 1 hour nga Vihar pa Cebu. So Negros is basically volcanic. That's why we did mention previous pa nga discussions nga the reason why dagko kayo ang lumber, no, sa Sagay, at the same time you are able to also transition, no, from lumber industry to agriculture, it's because arable or suitable for agriculture ang land ni Negros. Not just Negros Occidental, but apil na po si Negros Oriental. Because our soil is ideal for agriculture, and that is because of Mount Kanlaon. Okay, 80% of all arable land in the island region is cultivated, whether we cultivate coconut trees, corn, other agricultural products, lumber, no? So, kanatanan class, mabuhi region na siya sa Atuanga province because of our arable soil. Arable land, rather. Let us now proceed to the administrative regions. So, if we are going to divide, no, Negros Occidental into several municipalities and cities, mag-comprise si Negros Occidental og 19 municipalities and 13 cities. And if we divide it further into barangays, mahimo na siya og 662. Out of all the provinces in the Philippines, kita ang pinakadaghan, no, most chartered cities. When we talk about most chartered cities, that means nga kita ang pinakadamo nga na convert from municipality to city. And just like what we discussed last time, so conversion ni Sagay from a municipality to a city, it takes several years, no? Because you are basically going to pass several like laws, no? At the same time, that law has to be sponsored, magiba siya daghan kay nga proseso. So although, again, like what I've said, no, ngano last time sa geography, gi-separate man si Bacolod, because it is different, no, because it serves as the capital. But again, even though it serves as the capital or the seat of power sa Negros Occidental, it is governed independently as a city. Now let's proceed to the demographics. Although the demographics is not recent, no, it's outdated. But this is the demographics presented as of 2015. So actually, gin-compare na mo, no, ang 2015 to 2024. Gamay man lang siya ang napuno. Siguro at least a million. Kaya ang population, there are cases nga we exclude Bacolod since it is the seat of power man, no? But if you include it, syempre, madaghan po na ang inhabitants or ang computation na to sa total population of Negros Occidental. So actually, as of 2015, ang census na to is 2,497,261. Sa 2020, so gamay raman ang napuno, no? Naa sa 2,623. We are still 8 out of 81 provinces, no? Ang most populated. 2024, I think around 3, no? 3 million. Okay. Okay, so far, ang sa 2020 pa man ako ang nakita, no? Usually nasa mga 2,600,000 plus. 2,600,000 plus. So, gamay naman ang napuno, no? So, with density of 320 inhabitants. So, imagine, no, per square kilometer, nasa 320 inhabitants. And if per square mile, nasa 830 katao ang maigo sa per square or masulod sa isa ka square mile. If include ato si Bacolod, the total population is 3 million. Okay? Sa 2024, naa sa around 3,600,000 plus. Okay? 600,000. So, with a density of 384 katao, no, per square kilometers and 995 katao per square miles. That's why out of 81 provinces, naata sa number 8. So, the residents of Negros are called Negrenses, no? Oftentimes, they are also called Negrosanons. And many are either pure mixed Austronesian heritage with foreign ancestry, like Chinese or Spanish. Take note, there are some, like the Gastons, no? There are some old nga mga, mga hacienderos, no, nga nag-start sa sugar industry here in Negros Occidental. Originally, they are not Negrenses. They actually came from Manila, no? Either foreigner sila or nakaminyo sila Pinay, or Pinoy sila nga nakaminyo sila og foreigner. And then they've noticed nga mas mo flourish man ano ang like sugar industry sa Negros Occidental or Negros Island, knowing that the soil is suitable no for agriculture, that's why they migrated from Manila to Negros Island. No, that's why makita to nga daghan kay mga mestizo, mestizas, daghan kaayo og kanang mix heritage no kay originally dili na sila taga diri no, naggikan na sila sa lain nga lugar, nag-migrate lang sila sa Negros Occidental. And take note guys no, ang reason why we are called Negros Island because the original inhabitants jud sa Negros Island kay na ay dark skin no, curly or kinky hair no, muna siya ang reason why we are called Negros no, from the word nga I think it's slander, meron naman siya og kanang racial slur karon no, but muna siya no, that's why Negros kay again it is described no, described to because of the skin no nato as the original inhabitants sa Negros Island. I will not explain further the word Negros no because either it could be like it will be misunderstood as a racial slur, okay, especially karon nga medyo sensitive na ang tanan nga mga tao. So Negros Occidental is predominantly a Hiligaynon speaking province, okay, so 84% of the residents in Negros Occidental speaks Hiligaynon, no? Why? Because most of you are facing Panay Island, Guimaras, who are Ilonggos, no? Native speakers sila sa Hiligaynon. Syempre, since you are near Panay Island, tendency is, okay, some of the municipalities and cities facing Panay Island can speak in Hiligaynon. But, for us, no? Kaming, we are on the other side. That's why you've noticed some of the municipalities and cities in Negros Oriental, they speak in Bisaya. In Dumaguete, they speak in Bisaya, but they have a certain tone, no? That is different. Their tone is different from San Carlosenyo. Okay? Ang Bisaya po namo, guys, is different from Cebuano. Cebuano is former, like, Isog, dud sila, no? Like, parsa ng mga Karayagon, like, there are several Hiligaynon speakers, no? Pero, when it comes to, like, Karaya, medyo strong ang ilang accent, no? Lahi ang ilang more sila on R. Ang mga Cebuano po are different than San Carlosenyos or mga Bisaya nga taga Negros, kay usually medyo gentle, okay? Medyo ya-ya. Sa Dumaguete, dili gani kayo ya-ya ay lahang kuan, lang Bisaya, no? Dili raman na sa San Carlos. Ang dito sa Cebu kay bundak jud no nga isog, okay, nga murag ga-argue, okay, so kami mo retain sa panamo may pagka medyo Hiligaynon ug kuan no, although dili man jud sa tone but the manner of speaking nga medyo slow man mi mo Bisaya no, that still remains because that's like one thing no nga ma-identify nimo sa mga Hiligaynon, so very like ayo to I've so spoken kay I've went to Iloilo no pala. Kusog man po sila mamalikas. Ayun to, if you can understand mamalikas. Mamalikas is like saying curse words, no? Or kanang, sana, kanang mag-say og, say og bad words, muna siya. So, usually, no? Mumana ilaha dito kay strong native speakers yun sila of Hiligaynon. Medyo na mix na mampod me. No? So, ila ito is medyo isog. No? Pero again, malumanay man, no? Mag-Cebuano, no? Mag-Bisaya ang mga San Carlosenyos. So, Cebuano is spoken by the remaining 16%. So, muna siya, no? Cities and towns facing Tanyon Strait. We are facing Cebu. So, due to the proximity to the island province of Cebu, a mixture of Hiligaynon and Cebuano is spoken in Sagay. If you've noticed, like, there are several, like, Sagaynons nga na-encounter na ko nga. They can understand Bisaya. They can also speak Bisaya. But mostly, ang predominant nila is ang Hiligaynon. Okay, pero syempre no sa inyo ha nga city mixed jud ang both. Because since you are located sa topmost or northernmost part of Negros Island, that's why natunga mo between Hiligaynon and Cebuano. But again, regardless of our differences in languages, all of us can speak Filipino and English for our educational, literary, and official purposes. Okay. So, Negros Occidental, given nga We're the most populous province in the entire Western Visayas region. Okay. We also have the second largest number of congressional districts and the seventh most populous, fourth if highly urbanized cities and independent component cities. Okay, if we include that one in the 2015 census. And even until now, I think we are still the most populous province given nga gaka-increase man ta, no? Hindi man siguro masyado ka drastic like before, no? Or like other provinces, no? But we still can say now we are the most populous province given nga na sa 2,600,000 if we include pagit sa Bacolod na sa mga at least 3 million plus. Now let us proceed to religion. Okay? So our province, no, are mostly Catholics yun nga to ang mga inhabitants, no? And one of the, I don't know if it's biggest, no, but one of the like largest dioceses can be found in Bacolod, San Carlos, and Kabangkalan. Okay? So over 2 million ang adherents, no, or those who practice Roman Catholicism. So there are actually other Christian denominations, no, that are basically may similarity sa ato ang religion as Roman Catholics, but ang uban wala sila gatuog santos, no? Ang uban wala sila ga believe in like Mama Mary, no? Like ang ilang tinuhuan, but still derived from the Holy Bible, no? Nalang yung mga only mga small differences ang ilang religion compared to Roman Catholicism. And those are Baptist churches, Aglipayan, Iglesia ni Cristo, Seventh-day Adventists, and Evangelicalism. So, we also have our Muslim brothers and sisters. Islam is adhered by a sizable minority with 1,842 na who practice, no, or ang ilang religion is Islam. Fast forward, okay. Let us now proceed to the economy. Now, as we all know, like I've kept on mentioning this one over and over, no, sa previous atong discussion, the lifeblood of the Negrenses is basically sugar industry. I think all of us already know nga wherever we go when we travel pa Bacolod or maski asa mo na kung syempre magita sa coastal lagang syempre maagian nga mga tubuhan. Pero kung dilipod mo sa kuano, dilipod mo sa although dili man siya nga nakadaghan, no? Kung dilipod ta sa Don Salvador Moagi, although na may mga uban agricultural products, makakita po may several Japon nga sugar plantations, no? Sugarcane plantations. Because again, ang naasa Manila, no, nga mga dons, mga hacienderos, no, they decided to migrate here in Negros Occidental and started the sugarcane plantation. And with this, no, nagkadaghan nun siya. That's why we are considered as the sugar bowl of the Philippines. Our tagline is Land of Sweet Surprises. Okay, because we produce more than a half of the country's sugar. Not only that, we even export our sugar outside of the Philippines. Well, this is possible because we have 15 sugar centrals located throughout the lowland areas across the north and west of the island, stretching from northwest along the coast of the Visayan Sea and Guimara Strait. And actually, guys, no, out of the 15 or 12 sugar centrals, 10 na lang ang function, no, up until this day. So, mga larger mills are found in San Carlos, La Carlota, Bago, Binalbagan, Kabangkalan, Sagay, Silay, Morsha, and Victorias. I was actually born and raised in San Carlos milling, no, sugar mill, no? Naman, nag-provide man silang houses po silang mga employees. Pero karon wala na siya nag-function, guys. No? Dugi na siya nasirado. Way before pa ko gipanganak, 1997, nasirado na siya. Okay? Maybe because of poor management siguro. Or I don't know. No? Other pa rin na factors siguro nga, no? Nag-shutdown siya. So, ang pinakadako dyan actually nga, sugar mill can be found in Victorias. Okay? Victorias Mill in Victoria City. It is the largest sugar mill in the country, and not only that, no, if si Insular Lumber Company is the biggest lumber mill in the world, ang nasa Victorias is the world's largest integrated sugar mill and refinery. You can even find the Angry Christ here. Okay. It's a famous mural painting na naa sa ilang chapel that can be found inside Victoria's Mill or Sugar Mill. Like what I've said, even though that we have a very strong sugar industry, no? Our lifeblood is the sugar industry. Sometimes dili man ta maka-rely on that alone. Na may times na na slump when it comes to the production of sugar. May kitag slump like dili man all the time nga maayo ang ato ang harvest, no, sa sugar or sugarcane. That's why our province rather relies also in other industries like fishing, agriculture and BPO. Apil lang po dahil ang mining, no? No, sirado naman noon siya sa silay. Pero at least before, no, we considered mining as one of the industries that we also rely on. Now, let's start with the fishing industry. So, the fishing industry can be found in Cadiz. So, they have several fish ponds that can be found not only in their city but all throughout, no? So, one of the country's largest copper mines are located in Sipalay City. So, kar na shutdown naman na siya, no? But before, they're able to dig up, no, several important like minerals, no? Napayoban nga mga non-metallic, no? Nga mga minerals where it can also be used for agriculture. Not only that, ga exists pod ang cottage industry. For the cottage industry, guys, no, like for example, municipalities like Calatrava, they produce pandan bags, pandan pouches, no, anything that is made from pandan, and that is very popular. Actually, I even have a pandan bag, no, nga, extra large siya nga para sa kong mga documents that is handcrafted in Calatrava. And then they also actually export, no, even to provinces like Cebu. Ginapalit na siya and then ginahand paint and ginabaligya, no? So most of the pandan bags that you see that are sold in like Cebu or Manila, ang ga-supply ana is coming from Calatrava. Tagabalo, no, kanang naa sa kultura, no, that also comes from Calatrava. So again, the province is rich in mineral deposits, no? And I think it's a no-brainer already, no? Okay? Knowing that our land is very arable, suitable for agriculture because of Mount Canlaon. That's why nga daghan po tag mga mineral deposits. Minerals that abound in the province are primary copper with estimated of 591 million metric tons and gold ore with estimated reserve of 25 million tons. If wala lang nagsirado si Sipalay, no, sa ilang operations in 2000, siguro dili siguro ang Toledo ang maoy ko ano or pinakadako nga mining it comes to copper. Because, di ba, si Toledo is considered as copper city. Oh, so, syempre, no, more sila into mining. Now, ang largest actually is not in Toledo but in Sipalay. Okay? But since nagsirado naman sila, no, they suspended their operation in 2000, maybe because it's not sustainable anymore, it's not good for the environment. So, muna nga, wala na ga-kuha og mga like copper, or kanang mga non-metallic minerals, okay? So, unsay other padjud aside from copper, silver and molybdenum are also very abundant in Silay, Sipalay rather. So, napod sila yung mga non-metallic minerals that are used for industrial and agricultural purposes. Okay? So, nadormant lang siya in the year 2000, yung pila nakatuig ang nalabay, no, wala nakabalik. So, in Sipalay, guys, daghan po kay sila, no, actually dili lang sila into mining but daghan po kay sila mga beautiful attractions, no, nga ilahang gina advertise mo na daghan kay awards actually ang Sipalay aside from other nga mga municipalities when it comes to tourism, no. Sipalay City also dominates, active kay na ilahang kanira, no, tourism officer. Let us now proceed to another napod nga industry. So, aside from agriculture, mining, fishing, so BPO companies are also one of the driving forces of our economy. In fact, during the pandemic, no, nga nag-stop ta na nag-travel, nga nag-work from home ta, nga especially ang greatly dyan nga na-affected is ang hospitality and tourism industry since wala may ga-travel, wala tayong mga tourists, wala tayong mga guest, so wala naman tay reason to operate aside from being made into a quarantine center. So, na yung mga daghan kayo nga na-lay off ato, kaya din naman sila ka-pay sa ilahang mga like wages or salary. So, na-lay off sila, wala sila'y trabaho. And then, ang natabo ato class, no? Wala, no? Nagtambay lang uban sa balay, or nag-negosyo na lang, or nag-online na lang na business, online jobs. But the one who carried it all, kasi since daghan man lang nag-trabaho during that time, especially the hospitality and tourism industry, ang nag-carry sa tanan, no, sa tuang concerns in the economy during the pandemic is the BPO, okay? Business Process Outsourcing, okay? And the reason why very abundant kay ang BPO, not just in Bacolod, but even in Cebu and Manila, it is because labor is cheaper in the Philippines and it's easy for us to be trained in BPO companies knowing that we are already proficient in speaking English, okay? So, in the whole Negros Island of the Philippines, si Bacolod na siya estimated workforce of 35,000 in IT BPO industry, working in major companies. So, sa many mga major companies nga nag-operate sa Bacolod City. So, we have Convergys, Teleperformance, TTEC, Focus Direct International, Bacolod Panasiatic Solutions, Ubiquiti. So, Ubiquiti, nakita na to sa, kung ano, Cyber Center, no, dira sa Bacolod, no, near Taitung, Transcom Asia, and I-Corps. As of 2019, Negros Occidental has a total of 13 operating PEZA-registered IT parks and centers. So again, guys, no, we rely so much on the BPO companies because even nag-pandemic, guys, nagpadayon na dyan po ng ilang services, they can work remotely, okay? Wala mo dyan totally, like, na-lay off tanan sa ilaha during the pandemic. Next, we have food and agriculture. Negros Occidental's output of more than 1 million metric tons for crop year 2002 to 2003 accounts for nearly half of the country's sugar production in an industry that generates an estimated annual revenue of more than 18 billion. So, since there are 12 to 15 sugar mills in the province, 10 are presently operational. Nakakontribute po si Victoria's Milling Company with a rated capacity of 15 tons cane per day. So again, wala lang tanang salig sa sugar. Naabot ay other agricultural products, no? So unsa man ni sila, no? Usually like bananas, fruit crops, fruits. Pinaka-common actually is ang copra. Mundo na siya, corn. Copra from coconut trees, no? So, muna siya kung giingon kanina, guys, no? The volatility of the sugar industry forced the province to shift. So, again, dili man ta solely ka rely lang sa sugar industry kay dili man dyan ding anak ka booming all the time. So, nag-transfer sila sa alternative industries like rice, root crops, okay? So, muna, production of rice. So, annual output sa 2003 is 437,000 metric tons of palay. Okay. So, hybrid rice. And then, fruit and vegetable crops. Except for banana and cassava, the rest ng mga fruit and vegetable crops ng improve ilang harvest. Okay? And since, no, we are also doing well in agriculture, no, coconut, as a good kaan pa harvest, no, with 139 million nuts, and then banana, fruit and vegetable crops with a total of 110 million kilograms. So not only that, no, ang mga Negrenses also delved into livestock and poultry. So raising cows, pigs, no, mababuyan, poultry, chicken, no, eggs. So, since we're able to quarantine foot and mouth disease, bird flu, we're able to contribute so much when it comes to livestock and poultry. Other than livestock, poultry, agriculture, fishing is also an industry nga ginafokusan sa province. Out of 19, no? 19 municipalities, 13 cities, 9 of its cities and 16 of its municipalities are located along the coastline and has a great portion of the population that depends on fishing for their livelihood. Personal sa mo, ano, we have Sipaway to thank for because lively man ang mo ang fishing industry dito because of Sipaway. I know in Sagay, you know, since before mo ning move mainland, no, fishing man jud ang inyong main source of livelihood. Okay. I'll take a short 5-minute break for a while. Please don't leave. Nalang jud ko'y asikason kadali. Just a very short 5-minute break. And then I'll come back. Kadali lang jud kayo. You can take water break. No? Ay lang jud mo og leave kayo. Padayon naman tag-klase. So I'll pause the recording. Okay. Okay, so let us continue. So that was a very short 5-minute break lang kadali, no? Let us proceed. So we are now actually at the culture and the arts, and then we are going to stop by festivals, and then the infrastructures, we are just going to continue that one by next meeting. Infrastructures, landmarks, and then media. Okay, so 3 topics ato yung pabilin for next meeting. Again, for those who just came in, we are going to end our class a bit early lang since I have an oral defense with the masteral students this evening, 7 to 9 p.m. So, since I'm one of the panelists, I have to be on time. And that's why I will just let you go by 7. Wait lang. And share screen ko lang. Okay, let us continue with culture and the arts. So, Negros Occidental has long been a center of culture and arts. A wealth brought about the sugar industry made sure that the Negrense Principalia enjoyed an above average standard of living. And actually, when it comes to culture and the arts, I think the most appropriate place to go to is Silay. No? Silay has perfectly preserved to 30 of their heritage houses. Although, no, may similarities man sila ni Iloilo, which is also the city of love. It is considered as Ciudad sang Panghigugma. Not only because, syempre, ang ilahang historical buildings and infrastructures are still preserved up until this day. And it has a kind of, okay, since, syempre, no, it has some kind of marag nostalgic, no, ang feeling na makuha ni mo because karaan man ang mga houses and also the infrastructures, even their commercial buildings there in Iloilo, guys. Karaan na Japon kay siya. Pero syempre, may modern twist lang gamay kay mga bago man ng mga shops ang nakabutang dira, nakaplastar. But it makes it more romantic because of the nostalgic feeling that you get from their preserved heritage houses and infrastructures or commercial buildings. In Silay, the same can be said with Silay, no? It is nicknamed as the Paris of Negros. Okay? Then Paris is also considered as a city of love, no? Muna magkigtigi dyan si Iloilo o si Silay sa, you know, because we consider anything that is nostalgic as romantic. So, Paris of Negros si Silay, city of love si Iloilo, syudad sang panghigugma. But both of them have similarities and that is their heritage houses. So, Silay is the center for cultural and artistic center of Negros Island region. Not only because of the 30 heritage houses that have been declared by National Historical Institute, but it is also the hometown, no, of the national artist of the Philippines for architecture, Leandro Locsin, and international mezzo-soprano Conchita Gaston. And their hometown in Silay Okay. Ilang balay, syempre, is ang Balay Negrense. Okay, Balay Negrense, out of the 30 heritage houses, the most popular. Oh, heritage houses, ha? Ang the ruins is considered as a mansion. So, another famous treasure of Negrense art and heritage can be found in Victoria City. I did made mention of the Angry Christ, which is in Victoria's Milling Company. That is inside their chapel. And not only that, is it's very renowned, no, in Negros Occidental. It's also renowned worldwide. Okay, si Angry Christ, it is painted with vibrant colors like blue, red, orange, yellow. Okay, and may pagka Picasso, no, di ba exactly like Picasso, pero may pagka Picasso kay kanang the painting is just like stained glass. Kailangan mo stained glass sa cathedral. Ngayon, ano nga kind of art. It's painted with vibrant colors and then angry. No? Ang nahong sa ni Christ. Siyempre, na ay Holy Spirit or Dove na naa sa ceiling and also God the Father nga nasa pinakababaw. Okay? So, ang God the Son, si Jesus Christ, naa sa ubos, no? Which is the wall behind the altar. And it's so big, no? Actually, dako kayo na siya ng mural. And then, abot pa dyan na sa ceiling. So, who painted actually the Angry Christ? It's painted by artist Alfonso Osorio, which is a scion of the Osorio family who owned the mill. The Negrense's joie de vivre is manifest in the various festivals all over the province, foremost being the famous Mascara Festival of Bacolod, Pasalamat Festival of La Carlota, and Bailes de Luces of La Castellana and Pinta Flores Festival of San Carlos. So, actually, damo pa gina siya ng mga festivals that you can find in Negros Occidental. Ang mga famous lang, no, at least nakaabot sila, like, example, like sa San Carlos City, ang first festival queen sa Sinulog, no, nakadaog sa festival queen is from San Carlos City. They represented Pinta Flores Festival and syempre, nincompete sila sa Sinulog. No. So, not only that, no, not only that we competed in Sinulog, no, so, dala na po sa abroad, no, sa mga festivals like sa Korea, mga international festivals, so, na po nakasayaw dito, nag-present ang Pinta Flores Festival. Okay, so, since we did made mention of festivals, as other cultural events, no, in Negros Occidental. Okay, aside from paintings, old heritage houses, the festivals mentioned na ang maoy clear jud kay nga depiction of culture, no? And usually festivals are there to as a way to thank, no, patron saints or patron saint, no, or thanksgiving for good harvest, good life. In fact, the panaad sa Negros Festival is also somewhat of a promise or a vow, no, for a good life, and it's also a form of thanksgiving. But syempre, it's a combination of all the festivals throughout Negros Occidental. Wait for a while, let me charge my laptop first. Kali lang. So, what brings all of the festivals together is actually the Panaad sa Negros Festival. This is held every April at the 25-hectare, 3-line Panaad Stadium in Bacolod. So, here in Negros Occidental, we call it the Festival of Festivals because Panaad brings together the 13 cities and 19 towns in a showcase of history, arts, and culture, tourism, trade, commerce, industry, beauty, and talent, as well as games and sports. But this is not like festival in festivals sa Tibuok, Philippines, ha? Kay in Cebu, they call it Pasigarbo sa Sugbo. Syempre, we are Negrense, so in Hiligay noon, panaad means vow. Okay? So, ang ilaha is, syempre, in Bisaya, ang panaad, no, is vow or promise. It's a Hiligay noon word. Panaad sa Negros. Ang festival of festivals nila sa Cebu is called Pasigarbo sa Sugbo. Pasigarbo is to showcase, no? Ipasikat, mamana siya sa Cebuano. And then Sugbo, okay, so kung kita panaad sa Negros kay Negros man, Sugbo is their term, no, or another word for Cebu. Okay? Sorry, next. Okay. It's another term for Cebu. Like for example, ginatawag nila ilang mga Cebuanos other than Cebuanos in Bisaya, they also call it Sugbuanons, okay? And then Sugbu ilang tawag sa Cebu in Bisaya, no? That's why muna Pasigarbo sa Sugbo. Mother of all festivals is ano, sinulog. Okay, so the Panaad sa Negros Festival, also simply called as Panaad Festival, also sometimes spelled as Pana then dash ad, is a festival held annually during the month of April in Bacolod, which is the capital of Negros Occidental. Before siya, guys, ang Panaad no na transfer sa what do you call this? Before siya na transfer sa Panaad Park, okay, or Panaad Stadium, daghan po kayo na siya og venue, no, si Panaad sa Negros, no. Originally naam siya sa Capitol una, and then kamadugayan, no, daghan na mag nag-appeal, daghan na nag-join sa Panaad sa Negros. They had to change it to the reclaimed area, no, near the Breadco Port. And then later on, since damo naman kaayo ang mga mo-appeal, later transfer it permanently sa... Okay. So, they transfer it permanently to Panaad. Okay, Panaad Stadium. So, again, it is derived from the Hiligaynon word for vow or promise. The festival is a form of thanksgiving to divine providence and a commemoration of a vow in exchange for a good life. The celebration is held at the Panaad Park, which also houses the Panaad Stadium, and is participated in by 13 cities and 19 towns of the province. For this reason, sometimes, other than the festivals, we often dub, no? Panaad as the mother of all the festivals of Negros Occidental. Okay. So before we proceed to infrastructure, just again, no, another na po na to nga information, additional information lang sa Panaad Festival. So like what I've said, the original jud, no, pinakauna jud nga location sa Panaad Festival was held at the Lagoon, fronting the provincial capital. So, they lasted actually 4 years, no? Nga dito sa provincial capital sila, sa Lagoon sila, nag-held sa Panaad Festival. So, nag-grew man siya each year. They need to look into a more spacious venue. So, that's why in 1997, like what I've said, niagto sila sa reclaimed area near the Breadco Port. Later on, na-construct naman ang Panaad Stadium, and then, nanapod ang Panaad Park, so muna na ang permanent home of the Panaad Festival. So, when did the Panaad Festival started? It started in 1993. It used to be like a three-day affair, a three-day event. And then, that's why it's held every April, because April 30 man siya nag-start atong year 1993. Okay? So, we are going to proceed with infrastructure by... next meeting, actually, kanira mo no infrastructure, and then we have landmarks. Ano yung mga landmarks na ni sila? After landmarks, we have media. And then, we're done, no? So, three topics na lang ito ang i-discuss by next meeting. So, we are going to end early for this evening. I have a final oral defense pang atinan. And then, I'll just call your attendance. I didn't bring my attendance sheet. Okay. So, I'll just take a photo of the attendance that is automatically generated. automatically generated sa Google Meet. Okay, let me just stop sharing. By the way, guys, do you have any questions or things that you'd like to clarify? So we will just continue with the remaining topics by